Hey everybody, it's Genghis John here, and this evening we are playing Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds. This is an older game that I used to play all of the time. It's actually the game where I first came up with the name Genghis John, so pretty significant in that sense. This game originally came out at some point after Episode 1 was released with six different... I guess I should back up and say it's a real-time strategy game, and it had six factions. Let's see, the Gungans, the Naboo, Trade Federation, Rebel Alliance, Empire, which was six factions with different campaigns. There's a standard game mode with different conditions of victory, things like that. Then after Episode 2 came out, there was an expansion called Clone Campaigns, which is what I am playing now, which added factions and campaigns for Old Republic, and the Confederacy. So the purpose of this series is not going to be how to, you know, to teach you how to play the game. Instead, what I'm going to start off doing is by playing one episode from each campaign. Actually, I'll show you who we got here. So all of these different campaigns plus two more for the episode two campaigns you can see there. What I was saying, I'm going to play one episode from each campaign just to sort of show you what those look like. And maybe play a few standard games based on that. I would love your feedback on what campaigns you would want me to play in full, and what standard game types you would want to see. Basically I'm recruiting you to get into the game and tell me what you want to see at this point. We are going to start off actually with the Trade Federation campaign. We're going to be playing the first episode. I am going to actually play through, and then I'm going to be commenting over it after the fact, sort of like a battle report. So I hope that you enjoy. Sit back and relive the Trade Federation invasion of Naboo from Episode 1.
Transmission 0147JS. Location, Naboo. Encoded to Darth Sidious. Viceroy Newt Gunray transmitting. Naboo is a green-blue marble in space, my lord. A peaceful planet, barely able to resist our overwhelming forces. It waits patiently for the Trade Federation's touch. Queen Amidala and her people know nothing of our approach.
All right, here we go. Trade Federation campaign objectives. We're taking out basically a communications array. We just got to keep our hero alive. Intelligence sort of tells you how to attack, how to complete your objectives. Reconnaissance is going to tell you about the map. So in this one, we're going to be taking on three relatively small outposts. Basically a sneak attack, right? This is like the paratroopers going in on D-Day.
Proceed, Viceroy.
I have a task
for you. So we're starting off with some basic troopers. We've got what are called beetle droids, which are nice anti-building units, anti-mech units.
New center seems to be well defended.
So like he said, there's a lot of enemies situated there, so we're going to forego attacking this encampment for now till we get reinforcements. And then U9's in the tank.
We are sending
so here's Beast opening our attack. You just saw the reinforcements coming in from the back. We're gonna start attacking the troop center. And we're gonna be attacking the troopers, the enemy troopers, as they come in with our troopers to leave our beetle troopers unmolested. And we've also got the droid decals, which are nice because they are shielded, so they can actually soak up twice as much damage. So we're just trying to get rid of this troop center, and then just off to the right, that is the communications array. So as soon as we eliminate the enemy's ability to regenerate troops, we're going to go after the communications array. All of the different units, you can put them in different stances. So all of the ranged units I am placing in defensive stance, which just means that they are going to shoot anything that comes near that will potentially harm them. I'm actually going to pull them out of the city. No need to do extra, you know, unnecessary collateral damage. And we're just going to go straight for that communications array. The Beatles, they are currently in defensive stance now. Usually, you know, once they're in the middle of the action, I put them in a more aggressive stance where they will just automatically attack any enemy buildings or units that come nearby. They are vulnerable to ranged attacks. We're just going to have them follow behind our Trade Federation hero U9 here as we move on towards the next city, which is the one we skipped over before. Small Naboo patrol, no problem for us. We're just knocking them down as soon as they pop up. Got some droids harvesting Nova crystals. We are taking them out before they can garrison and shoot back. You see an enemy mech speeder coming in. With all that concentrated fire, you know, nothing that the enemy can throw at us in this level at least is going to be able to withstand to that kind of concentrated firepower. So. Yeah, this is really just sort of an introductory level. We really haven't taken a whole lot of casualties. I've put them in a stand your ground stance. They're not going to go out and actively find things to kill, but they will attack enemy units that come too close. Basically, they're laying down a cover fire for the Beetle droids here to get in and destroy that communications tower. You saw those Naboo troops up towards the top of the screen earlier. I'm not sure why they're not attacking. And you've got turrets over there and a gate. So really, we just came in the back door. And they're staying out of our way, so all the easier. We're just gonna, even though they've surrendered, we're just sort of kicking dirt in their face at this point. And we're gonna make them follow U9, and we're gonna move on to the third and final town. So as far as civilizations go, there's all different kinds of buildings. Basically, you know, you want to collect resources. It's going to allow you to build stuff. So you see all these crystals, you know, there's ore, there's Nova, there's food, there's carbon. And different resources are going to allow you to build different buildings, recruit different kinds of units, and research different technologies. Again, all of this is fairly meaningless in this game. It's pretty much just a straight combat mission. And each town is pretty weak individually. They don't pose much of a threat. Just a random, you know, Naboo army out in the forest. Here's Parley. They are definitely better defended. So we are going to send our Beetle droids in to attack those turrets. So once they get in close to the turrets, they're not going to be able to to get shot at. It is provoking a response from the Naboo, though. They're definitely coming out. They have something to say about us coming in and attacking them. We have some pummels. They're very, very heavily armored. I did get a little careless with my beetle droids on this level. I didn't have my range troops up close enough to give sufficient cover to where they were sort of slowly getting picked off. Swarming that turret with all kinds of stuff. Really, here's where it got bad, with more of their troops able to just swarm in and pick off my beetle troopers, and the slower pummels. You know, no matter how heavily armored they are, if they get swarmed by enough stuff, especially those enemy mechs that you saw, they'll take damage. They'll die straight up. So they're just attacking some prefabricated shelters while the rest of the squad rolls in. The mechs definitely pose the biggest threat, followed by the mounted troopers who try to kill those guys first before they're able to blow up the pummel. As soon as they saw that right there. Yeah, their mechs sort of wrecking our troops right now. So we gotta take those up ASAP. Droidica's so clutch, able to soak up so much damage, do a lot of damage in turn. And we got them for free. Normally, you know, in a standard game, you'd have to build them. They do cost a decent amount to make. So those guys are all set at stand ground stance. Just gonna lay down cover fire before anything gets too close. Pummel's gonna go grab that turret, take care of it. I do venture a little close with my ranged units to this turret. The turret's able to take out a couple troops before I pull them, you know, before I realize it and pull them back. That droid to come making short work of those Naboo troopers. It's just a matter of time. Trade Federation, too much to handle. True to form, true to the movies. Security force, no match for a trained professional droid army. This communications relay, definitely harder to get to with the heavier walls, with the gate. Takes a bit more to punch through that stuff, but no problem for the pummel. You can see the Naboo troopers aren't even really going after the pummel. In fact, it looks like that they're just trying to walk by for some reason. And then our ranged troops able to just pick them off. I didn't even have to blow up the gate because the gate was opening to let enemy troops through. So I was just able to sneak through, blow up that small gate, and now we are attacking the communications relay. Naboo in full retreat mode at this point. They're just not able to produce enough troops to fight back. And there you see we complete the objective, get the victory. There's a nice little end cinematic.
But it is just the beginning of our invasion.
Boom. So there it is. That is the first episode of the Trade Federation campaign. Got the dub. I like the straight combat one. Some of the more civilization building ones take a bit longer, so I think that this is a good introduction into the game. So hope you enjoyed. If you liked the video, please like, consider subscribing to the channel. Let me know in the comments what you thought, what other scenarios you would like to see me play. Thanks for watching. This has been Genghis John signing out. Until the next video.